My parents were both musicians. My father played a guitar, and my mother a trumpet, and yeah. So there was music in my house, and I started playing the piano. I started lessons at the age of 6. And a few years later, I started in a boys' choir. I didn't want to, but but my parents drove me, said, "We are gonna drive to meet someone." And I didn't know it was going to be an audition for a boys' choir. But I loved it from the first day, actually. So, and that was the age of 10, I think. In the choir, in the boys' choir in the Cathedral of Trondheim, it's a quite well-known boys' choir, actually. There's a conductor called, his name is Bjørn Mo, a very great conductor, and so he has been an influence for me from the beginning. As I sang in the boys' choir, I got very passionate about choral music, and especially melodies, everything from simple melodies for the services in the cathedral, psalms and hymns, and also the big works. I got to sing Mozart's Requiem and other big works. So I don't know, at some point I just thought, will it be possible for me to write something? Is that possible? And I just tried and bought myself a notation software program and started notate what I have written on the piano, and yeah, started to just play with it. And it wasn't very good, but that was how I started. I often have sit on the piano and just improvising, so I can just press record and just sit there to and improvise. And I can sit there for like for 30 minutes, and I might end up with some ideas that could work for a 5-minute piece. And I like that way of making music, because I don't have to stop and write down the notes, every single note. Then I can just listen to the recording and see what's useful and not. And, but other times I can get a melody in my head outside walking. So there's some pieces I know where I've written them, like, oh, that was at that shopping mall. And yeah, so, and then I take the melodies with me home and work with them. So it often starts with a melody and some harmonies, and then I will work more concentrated on the form. As I said, I was in a boys' choir from early, from the age of 10, and I had some wonderful, great spiritual experiences at that early, actually. Especially in services, where the cathedral was full and we walked in a procession, or what you call it here,
yes.
singing a psalm. And that was quite a big experience. And I was introduced to a lot of sacred music, singing in a cathedral choir. So I'm sure that's the main reason for my interest in sacred music. And today I write maybe 50-50 if it's sacred music or secular music. Yeah, well, it was the conductor of a girls' choir in Trondheim, in a cathedral, Anita Brevik. She has worked with Anton Armstrong before, and they were going to make a production together with the St. Olaf Choir and the girls' choir. And Anita played, I didn't know this, but Anita played a couple of pieces of mine to Anton, and he wanted to include it in this in this show, which was the Christmas in Norway with the St. Olaf Choir, and it aired on PBS and the biggest national TV station in Norway in 2013.
Well, I was one of probably a million people, if not more, that were watching the St. Olaf Christmas special in 2013 when they performed one of his works, Even When He Is Silent. As soon as I heard that work on television, I knew that that would be a perfect piece for the Opus Chorale. So as I was looking for new music for the spring of 2015, I thought I would go to the internet and see what I could find. I entered Kim's name into a search, and one of the links that came up was his Requiem. I didn't know that he had composed a Requiem. So as I listened to the excerpts that he had on YouTube, I decided that this again would be a wonderful piece for the Opus Chorale to perform. So I sent him an email asking him where I could purchase copies of the Requiem. And he emailed back saying that it was not in print yet. I asked him, has anybody asked him to do it yet, to perform it yet? And Kim said, no, not yet. It had just been premiered in April of 2014, and I'm contacting him in August. So it was still, you know, brand new, practically. As the conversation unfolded, we narrowed down to the possibility of having the Opus Chorale give the American premiere of this work. So once we nailed down that invitation, I took it back to the group and I said, this is a once-in-a-lifetime experience for us to do this. Do we want to take this on? Because it's going to be a huge undertaking. And they unanimously said, absolutely, we want to do this.
Suddenly I started getting emails from conductors and choirs in the US also, and not only musicians but also from the audience that started sending me emails that they heard my piece in Connecticut or in LA or different places in the US, and that was really exciting. With a 7-movement or 8-movement work as this Requiem, every movement doesn't have to have a form of a short piece that that should start and build up and end, you know. And so in a big work with several movements, you can end some movements differently. They doesn't have to have like you feel it's finished, you know. It can end with a question or leading up to something new later on. So one of my favorite pieces as a child was Mozart's Requiem, which I performed a lot. And later I discovered other Requiems that had quite a great impact on me. Understanding that I wanted to be a choral composer, specializing on choral music, writing a Requiem was to me the one of the greatest challenges I could get. So I actually started writing a Requiem at the age of 19. And I actually wrote, I think it was 6 or 7 movements at that time. Yeah, so I remember going on tours with my boys choir, and I bought I took a keyboard with me on the tour, so I sat at the hotel room and wrote my first Requiem, but it doesn't exist now, and it's not any good at all. But I did, so I think that says something about my fascination for Requiems. So I got this commission from this boys' choir that I sang in myself. So it was the Nidaros Cathedral Boys Choir who commissioned this work. And it was up to me what kind of work it was going to be. And when I got this big commission, I knew that this time I should write a Requiem and do it properly. And, yeah. I really like the old Requiem text, but I wanted to find a few texts that perhaps could make it a little bit more relevant for people today. I had a few publications in Norway, but suddenly things started to happen in the US with a lot of performances and interest from conductors and choirs in America. Cradle Hymn was my first publication at Santa Barbara. The biggest work that is coming out now is my Magnificat, which was originally written for SSAA chorus, but it will be published for also SATB, actually. So that's a 7-movement work that I wrote. So it has been a lot of work lately now, getting all the scores ready. But that's really exciting. And I'm really thankful for the interest from both choirs and conductors and companies like the J.B. Pepper. I'm really thankful for their interest in my works. I feel so welcome and included in the world of choral music in the US. I'm really thankful for that.